at the Tyson mansion, right?
I'm spending that way because I wasn't on a private plane at that point.
Okay.
You see what I'm saying? So I'm going, I'm not allocating the cost for flying private and doing different things with the lifestyle that we do.
Right.
I'm saying I'll spend $7,000. I don't give a fuck about that. I bought the house. It was only $4.1 million. I made $38 million the first tour. You know what the tour is like.
Oh, yes.
You come back off the tour, you like, what? How much money I got? I'll buy whatever the fuck I want. You see what I'm saying? So you look and you go, okay, I'll get the property. I bought the property in a direct wire transfer. If you remember, Mike Tyson owed the IRS $37 million when I bought the property.
Damn.
So they would have contested it, stopped it if it wasn't in a direct wire transfer. Mm-hmm. So I did it. Monica was his wife at the time. I got the property. Cool. Boom. When I got shot, Homo pulled the trigger. He was a part of Mike's camp. Part of Mike Tyson's camp. Now, I'm going to tell you some real shit, right, Spen? So, the nigga said, Mike Tyson can't stand Floyd Mayweather. He hate that nigga. Now, look at this. Look. Floyd, the illest shit is, I love the nigga like a brother. So, the nigga's talented. He is our champion.
Yeah.
For this time period. Like, you watch him, nigga crazy as a motherfucker and all that, but he's our champion. You know what I'm saying? So, look, and they're going to do a lot of things, but they're not going to beat that nigga.
Nah, they're not gonna be
until he's too old. When he got a fight, when the nigga finished the money and he gotta take a fight, and he's too old, so he take the fucking fight, and the nigga see it, and he throw the punch, but the shit get there late. And nigga hit him. And he starts seeing three niggas at one time. You know what I'm saying? It start getting crazy. But look, it's real shit. Mike told me, look, the first time this nigga had a rape charge. Look, this the first time Mike Tyson was charged, well, he had somebody that was claiming he raped him.
Yeah.
Floyd was paying for that bitch's lawyer.
What?
At that. He was paying for a girl to say Mike Tyson raped
him. Stop, man.
See, while you see him, the nigga, at this present moment, the one that would be the one that be all about the money. It's the money. It hurt him to watch Mike when he was the nigga and he was all about the money. And he had the money. So he said, when the girl claimed that Mike raped her, Mike ran into the girl and she changed her mind. Now, Mike, look, he had a lot of things. This is a tough nigga, Mike. This is a tough nigga to him, like, for real. But this nigga, he like a bitch he buy a 4Runner. Right? He like it, so he bought a bitch of a car, right?
All
right. Now, what the fuck you think she gonna do to reciprocate that appreciation?
Hey, what she gonna do?
She has nothing. This motherfucker wanna suck a dick, go fuck you. She wanna do something to reciprocate how she feels about what you just did for her.
The burn.
Right. And nigga might get communication problems. She knew he was gonna want some pussy, so but he just didn't know, she didn't know he wanted to fuck in the ass. You know what I'm saying? So it got a little carried away. But she felt like she probably could stop the nigga from doing what he was doing. At the end of the day, what really fucking happened is he met this bitch, he liked this bitch, he hung out with her, and he bought the motherfucker for her. And then this nigga paid for somebody to create that confusion because he was jealous at that point, man. The nigga was the nigga at that point, man. If anybody's confused, Mike Tyson did something different when he was the champion. See, he convinced the nigga that nobody in the world could beat him.
He convinced the whole world that shit.
Yeah, because I'm looking like this nigga said Mike Tyson, March 19th, Razor Ruddy. If he doesn't die, it doesn't count. Then a Campbell's Soup commercial came out. I'm in the neighborhood like, oh shit, that nigga meant that shit. They put that shit on TV? On national television? It felt different, man, because he was out there. Floyd different. Floyd is not a street person. He's a gym person, man. He's been raised to be what you see him do. from the beginning. Like, nigga, never threw a punch the wrong way. He had his daddy there to show him to throw it the right way. He had Roger there to show him to throw it the right way. Right? And when shit died out, right, now it's a quiet point. It's a quiet point for him. Because a fighter is only exciting when he has a fight in front of him. And when you're saying that, this would be the biggest thing that happens that I even mentioned it. But Mike Tyson told me this is some real shit. Mike Tyson called me, Floyd was getting ready to go to jail. We at the M Casino. Mike Tyson said, come here, let me talk to you for a second. And he pulled me outside the door. The nigga pushed the door, then the door opened, he came outside, he said, yo, I used to hate that nigga. The nigga voice changed, it got deep. You know how Mike Tyson is like, yeah, you all the way up here, Tim. You all the way up here. This nigga said, yo, I used to hate that nigga.
I can't fuck with you!
I said, oh shit, look, I'm like this, look. So I'm sitting there going, I got to fight this nigga, right? I'm thinking I might have to fight this nigga. He said, look at this shit, bitch. I'm in a fucking Cadillac, right? He pointed to a fucking Cadillac. It was, the shit was fly, it was a Cadillac truck.
Yeah.
But to Mike, the shit was some bullshit because it was a Cadillac, right?
Right.
He going, look at me, 50, I'm in a fucking Cadillac. He said, yo, I broke my TV every time that nigga fought. And then he shifted, he said, yo, the nigga's just that good. He's just that good. You know what I'm saying? He said, I'm glad you with that nigga. Help him. He not going no 50, he's me. He going to keep going. He going to keep spending the money, doing everything. He's me, 50. Help him. And he jumped in the truck and left. Scared the shit out of me for a minute because I thought I had to fight this nigga, too. I'm like, this, look, everybody else inside the fucking casino. I come outside. This nigga said, I used to hate that nigga. Nigga voice changed everything. I said, oh, shit. I'm going to have to fight this nigga. I'm going, yo, this nigga, I swear to God, man, Craig was there. Craig was with Mike Tyson. These niggas will tell you this shit. It's honest to God, true. I don't have a reason to lie. You know what I'm saying? And at that point, niggas say, I'm like, yo, what the fuck? Nah, I'm out here, it's just me and Mike. We gotta fight this thing. You know what I'm saying? This nigga, I'm like, oh shit. Then it just went a different direction than he went and got in the car. But see, look, even the, look at this. When I got hit, right?
Mm-hmm.
I got shot 9 times. Homo used to be in my camp.
Mm.
The next fight, I'm banged up. I'm up top of my fucking hip. Feel like you got a headache in it. This shit banging. Boom, boom, boom. Mike threw the next fight and dedicated to the nigga that shot me. I said, oh yeah? Fuck you and that nigga. Right? And I'm feeling like that because I'm hurt.
What the fuck you had going on, man?
Fuck you and that nigga. You know what I'm saying? But the real shit is when I actually got one, I'm telling this nigga, he's looking at me like, you ever seen a feature film play in front of a nigga in 3 minutes? Mike is looking at me like this. Yo, you's crazy, 50. You really eat this shit like this? Because he's looking like, with Jimmy Inchman and all these niggas, I ended up in beef with the craziest niggas you can think of.
Right.
And it's because I never picked the beef. I never picked it. I said, oh, it's a problem? No problem.
Right.
No matter who it is. Because if I didn't do anything to make you feel like the way you feel, I feel like I can't do anything to make you not feel that way. Some people want to go and explain themselves. They want to come talk to you and say, well, I feel like this because of this.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, look, the more success that you have in life is the more success that you can have from our culture, from hip hop. They don't necessarily see it like that. So a lot of the young niggas look and they want to discredit the success that already took place.
Mm.
At the end of the day, look, Noriega, I saw you did, you was talking on Nori's shit, right?
Mm.
And I got a kick out of that shit because Nori was the first nigga that did something with me.
Mm.
He had a tight relationship with John. I don't give a fuck what his relationship with them niggas was because he was the only nigga that looked out. We did. It ain't easy to make money. He got right on the record. The Trackmasters was like, why do you want established niggas to work with? Stout was like, oh, stay away from him a little bit, like.